Mississippi and New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden lead. This team is off the hook and you don't really want none. But if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. I tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run, or I can hit you with the pass.
On a warm late summer afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New England Patriots and the New York Jets. Gets fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Sony Michel calling no gain on the game's first play, and it's second down now. Delayed give there out of the gun. Defense was ready.
And I'm not a big fan of a draw play out of the shotgun formation because the quarterback's not having much action where he's getting away from the line of scrimmage. He's catching the football, making a little head fake, and then handing it off. You should be able to read it as they did there.
But he takes it up to the 40. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
Partner, is that what you call a quick hitter? That was actually a bolt of lightning, wasn't it? Right out of the gate.
And, of course, on the heels of him winning AFC Offensive Player of the Week 1 week ago. First down carry, it's Michelle. Avery Williamson there to make the stop.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Off the play fake. Here's Dobbs. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Out of the gun, Dobbs. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Well, let's see here, Charles. He was sacked six times last week. Now a first quarter sack. What's going on in his mind?
Well, he's thinking to himself, five offensive linemen. I got sacked six times last week. Let's start thinking about keeping extra people in. Tight end stays in. If I have a fullback or the running back, they stay in and help me block. Maybe not as many receivers in a pattern. Anything to try and slow down that pass rush.
Let's go! Ken Jusa.
The first carry for Trenton Cannon. And he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom. Quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and ten.
Hey, check. Tyler, 64. Weak. Right there.
Second and ten. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And finally down at the 9-yard line. That good for 22 and a first down. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends that might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spill the play before he gets there.
Second and goal from inside the five. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That second down play, that's a minus four.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought,
yeah,
is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Here's Dobbs to throw. That is caught by Williams. Touchdown, New England. Tyrell Williams. His sixth touchdown of the season as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Goskowski with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. Big yardage that time for the Jets. 43 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They're going to look to throw. And Anderson got it. And he's brought down after a very nice game. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
60 out now. First
down. Here we go. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Trenton Cannon. His second touchdown on the season as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Crew able to connect on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and that'll make it a second down. The 30 before he's hit and dropped. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Patriots in control of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. These two teams all tied after one. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. One-handed, what a catch. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
It's got to the point where we see guys like that make that type of a catch. Not fair goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right.
First down, Michelle.
These trips I had to go.
On a warm late summer afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New England Patriots and the New York Jets. Two 1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500, and we're underway here in week three. Gets fielded in the end zone, and he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the three. A big play there on the first play of the game. 72 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. They'll run for the first time with Trenton Cannon. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Trenton Cannon, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. Looking to throw on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. The 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Tyrell Williams, 91 yards as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. That's a great response. You give up the first score of the game, but you go right down yourselves and get the equalizer.
I just had a flashback there. I remember playing in a game like that in college where one of my teammates had said in the media that week, the opposite team would be lucky to cross our goal line. They crossed it in the first minute of the game. On our first offensive play, we scored to answer back. Something similar to what we just saw there.
Very similar to what we just saw. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and five. Here's Cannon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The corner, Stephon Gilmore, on the stop. You don't see that a ton, do you? With a cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Brings up third and three.
Let's go now. 18 Gator.
On third down, here's Cannon. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. Here's the Jets punter now. Back deep for New England, Julian Edelman. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 15. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Patriots take over. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook.
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. A big-time run there by Sony Michel. 43 yards.
How about our reigning AFC Player of the Week, hot-footing it into the secondary on that run.
Yeah, nice long run. That's what got him the award a week ago. Maybe he's trying for two in a row here this week. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Michel. And he'll take this one down to the 36. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of two.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Here's Dobbs to throw. It's caught. This is White. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat. Complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
On third down, Michel. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. Fourth down now after a loss of two.
I wonder if they just kind of outguessed themselves a little bit trying to run it on third down. Probably should have gone to the air to try and pick it up. Instead, the punting unit will have to run on the field.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Boy, on those punt returns for a touchdown, it just seems like 50% of the time there's a flag and there was there.
Yeah, and that number might even be conservative, right? I mean, every time we see it, we're excited by the play, but I know we're looking at the field waiting for a flag to come out. So many moving parts often leads to a penalty.
They're throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
They'll run on first down with Cannon. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves them with a second and three. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue, just make sure you feed me the football? And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
On third down, Cannon. And some space here. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Third and medium, they opted to run instead of pass, and it worked. First down. So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. They'll run with Cannon. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Lawrence Guy able to bring him down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. Dobbs to Michelle on the screen. And some room to work. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Sony Michel, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Patriots have taken the lead. Gostkowski the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. Pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break up their routes quickly as well.
On first down, Downs to throw. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. Throwing here, Downs. This is caught, and he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
From the shotgun, here's Dobbs. And Dobbs is going to be swallowed up as he'll go down.
Well, surprise, surprise. First and goal at the one. No quarterback sneak. No running play. They decide to throw for it, but the pressure got to him quickly and put the quarterback down.
Now from the nine, here's second and goal. To throw is Dobbs. That's complete. Right around the eight. Showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the five at the six. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. From the gun, Dobbs. That is caught by Williams for a New England touchdown. Tyrell Williams with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Extra point good by Gostkowski. And it's now 21-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. You got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. That one goes for 24 yards. 57 to Mike. Big stop, G. Big stop. Trying to pound it in here with Michelle. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Sony Michelle with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead.
I'ma tell you I'm a misconceiver, I'm a believer.